So here's the thing with being on a boat and going cruising is that doing your own maintenance is one of the absolute key pieces to being happy out on the water. Hi, I'm Nika Waters and welcome to the Boat Galley Podcast. Today we're talking about fixing deck leaks and I'm going to go over some steps to how to do it. You're listening to the Boat Galley Podcast. Tips, reviews, and how-tos for your cruising adventure. I'm Nika Waters, and this is Fit to Sail. This episode of the Boat Galley Podcast is sponsored by Schooner Chandlery, a nautical marketplace for you and your boat. Find traditional supplies for your new or classic boat, as well as nautical art and unique boating items from a wide variety of craftsmen. We also have the legendary free bag for incredible comfort aboard. Are you a nautical maker? Use the coupon code BOATGALLEY before March 2019 and sell your wares commission-free for all of 2019. Schooner Chandlery, traditional supplies for your classic boat.
Slow down.
Amazing. We love them. We have four of them on the boat. But every now and then, you get one that winds up getting a leak. And this happens with lots of deck fittings and lots of fittings in general. There are a couple of groups that I'm in where people are talking about having to rebed portholes and port lights and dealing with other places where you've cut holes in the boat for one reason or another to put in some piece of kit that you want to have on there, and then you get a leak. So how do you fix it? Well, I'm going to give you the steps. The first step, of course, is to notice that you have a leak. That's generally not hard. It's often hard to figure out where that leak is coming from, but if you have a hole in the deck and a fitting that comes through the deck, that's a pretty natural first spot. So the first thing is to notice the leak. The second thing you're going to do is choose what sealant you want to use. And depending on where your fitting is that you are rebedding, that's going to change the nature of the sealant that you're using. Life caulk or boat caulk is a great thing to use. I am currently a big fan of butyl tape. It looks like a piece of double-sided tape, sort of semi-thick, not super, super thick. But what it does is it's tacky. It's almost like it's almost kind of like blue tack. Remember the stuff that you used to hang up posters in college on the walls with long before they had, when you couldn't use double-sided tape and you wanted to have something that was going to come off, but you had something that was almost putty-like. And it would stay pliable. And butyl tape does that. It comes in similarly, it looks like double-sided tape, the roll that it comes on. So it's got some paper backing on both sides of it that wind up peeling off. Butyl tape comes in a bunch of different widths, and so you want to make sure that you're using the width that works for the purpose that you have. I think what I had was either half or three-quarter inch wide tape, and it worked just beautifully. Once you've decided what bonding material and sealant material you're going to use, then you keep going with the next part of the project. Remove the fitting very carefully. Sometimes the bonding that you've used or the sealant that you've used will adhere so well to the deck that it becomes really difficult to get it off. So you just have to watch that you don't make this project be a bigger one than you are expecting by being very, very careful about how you remove it. You may actually want to run a razor blade or something between the deck and the fitting to loosen any sealant so that it's not pulling up all the sealant that might actually pull up the gel coat or the deck with it. But you want to remove it carefully. And then I like to create some kind of a catchment system underneath the hole. So I just use a paper towel and some blue tape on the underside of the deck to make sure that anything that comes off of when I'm scraping and cleaning the old sealant off, it's not going into the water, but it also doesn't just generally make a big mess down below by going straight into a gaping hole. So I create a catchment system. The next thing you want to do is remove all the old sealant. You want to take all the old sealant both off of the fitting and off of the deck itself. Basically, that sealant or bonding material or whatever you used, in our case, it was probably some life caulk or boat caulk that we had used before. And any of that that's left can cause a way for water to get in. So you definitely want to make sure you take all of that off. If you're being particularly particular, you may want to even take a bronze brush or something and really, really, truly get every single last bit off of it. If I was being, if I thought that there were real issues with it or there was stuff that was being particularly stubborn, I would probably put a bronze, I can put a bronze wire brush onto a drill and actually use an electric drill to help truly clean all that stuff off. You also want to clean all of those surfaces with some kind of degreaser. Generally, some kind of a bonding or sealant that you've used will be a little bit greasy or have a little tackiness left to it. And so you want to clean those surfaces off really well. You can use something like acetone or alcohol. It's not particularly skin friendly, so be careful and you want to make sure you wear gloves. So the next thing you're going to do is deal with the sealant that you've chosen to use. If you're dealing with butyl tape, you measure out the length of butyl tape that you want to use. You cut it off. You pull the paper sealant off of the one side and put it down. And then when you're ready to put the other piece that is bonding to it, you just take then the other part of it off. But it's pretty easy to work with because you don't have to, you're not trying to deal with something that's sticky and tacky on both sides while you're trying to lay it down and get it in the right spot. To put the sealant down on one surface or the other, after you've put the sealant down on the deck or on the fitting, whichever one you want to do, you can do it on both sides if you want to, because the butyl tape will kind of fuse to each other like a fitting will. But if you're doing regular kind of caulking or even just regular butyl tape, you don't have to do a double layer of it, but I like to. Then you're going to put the prism or whatever your deck fitting is right down into it. You are going to set it right. You're going to fit it in the right spot. Once you pull the paper off of the top of the butyl tape and you press the fitting down into it, it will be pretty hard to move. You're not going to want to pick it up and put it down and pick it up and put it down. So you want to be pretty careful when you're putting it back onto the deck. And then you put your fasteners in. You want to make sure you are sealing the fasteners. And I use butyl tape for this too. What I did is I cut a tiny strip of butyl tape in half and then I folded it in half and I wrapped it around the top of the fastener and then was able to screw that right down into the deck. But that way the sealant is coming around the fastener and protecting the fastener, because if you don't put sealant on the fastener before you put it into the deck hole, you actually are inviting water getting into the deck. And what you definitely don't want to have is you don't want to have water getting between the fitting and the deck, because that can wind up causing deck rot and bigger problems down the line. Then after you have put your sealant on your fasteners, screw them down. And the thing with butyl tape is you don't have to, unlike some caulks or what have you, where you want to just tighten enough to start to have stuff squeeze out and then you're going to come back and tighten it down the next day. You don't have to do that with butyl tape. You can keep fastening it down. And what I do is I like to screw it down until I see a bead of the butyl tape coming out of the side. That way I know that it's in pretty good shape and it's not going to go anywhere and leak anymore. And then you clean up, you go down below and you pull your catchment system away. You look at all the cool things that you've collected in that paper towel and then put it right in the trash can and be really happy that it didn't go in the water. And then you wait for it to rain and you watch your leak and you realize that it doesn't leak anymore and you pat yourself on the back and you've done a great job. And then you start looking for the next leak, because really, probably there's another one coming sometime really, really soon. I look forward to hearing about your adventures in sealing your deck leaks and how you choose to rebed them. Here are a few tips on how you go about rebedding a leaking deck prism or any other deck fitting that you happen to have. I look forward to seeing you out there. Thanks for listening. If you like the show, please be sure to subscribe in your podcast app. Just search for the Boat Galley Podcast, and reviews are always appreciated. Until next time then.